Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic carbo-anion. Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about carbanion. Initially we have discussed about the carbocation, but this is what we are going to talk about, carbanion. So what is carbanion and what and how it has been formed? So let's talk about that. So now we are going to discuss about what is carbanion, and so for that let us understand the definition of it. So it says that a species in which the carbon atom bears a negative charge is called as carbanion. So similarly to that, what we have did in carbocation, we have did a lecture on carbocation, but it is very opposite to that in this case. That is, it will be a forming because of the heterolytic fission, but the thing is it will acquire a negative charge. Yes, so let me explain you with the help of an example. Suppose if we have a particular compound like this, and in this case basically the process of deprotonation has taken place. Deprotonation in the sense the removal of the hydrogen atom. So suppose if the hydrogen has a hydrogen atom in the form of that is proton, or in we could say in the form of H plus ion, it has been removed. So therefore we could say that the product that would be obtained is nothing but, so the product that would be obtained because of the heterolytic fission would be in such a way that this electron of the hydrogen atom will be acquired on the carbon atom, because we are doing the deprotonation. And that is the thing that we could get the product that is basically RC double bond O C H H over here, and one electron will be one extra electron will be on the carbon atom, and that makes it to be negative. Similar to that, what it has formed because of the heterolytic fission when we have discussed about the carbocation. So this is what it has been formed with, and now let us understand that what is the hybridization of it, or what would be the shape of this one. So since it is the one which consists of one electron more, and it is not electron deficient like that of the carbocation, so therefore we could call it as electron rich species, and that's the reason it has a negative charge over on the carbon atom. And since it has one electron more, so therefore it will follow the sp3 hybridization. So let me give you an example. I hope you will get it. That is, suppose the carbon that we are talking about in terms of the carbanion. So let us understand that we are talking about the carbon atom. So therefore, according to the electronic configuration, we could write it as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, sorry, 2p2. So this are the orbitals or representation of the orbitals that we have did over here. So therefore, this is the two electrons that will be occupied over here, and two electrons that would be occupied over here, and this is the one that is following Hund's rule. And the next thing that is, we have to excite it, because as you could see that the carbon is attached to three atoms, so that's the reason that we have to excite this one. So therefore, after the excitation, if you see, that is this orbital will have each electron, each orbital will have an electron in it. So therefore, I have written in this way. And meanwhile, if you see that the carbon is forming basically that is three bonds, and that also, suppose in this case, as we could see, because we are talking about the one which has one electron more, so that is the reason that it has been forming sp3 hybridization. So how, let me give a short glimpse of it. This is not the actual thing that I am talking, but this is just a small glimpse. As we could see that one electron is more here, over here, so therefore when we are talking about C minus, or when we are talking about carbanion, so therefore one electron would be here, as it suppose it is here, and this will be occupied, or this vacant space or vacant orbital, so it will be occupied by the hydrogen or by the different atoms. So suppose this is of the different atom that has been occupied. So in this case, basically overall we could see that there is a involvement of s and 3p orbitals, so therefore making it to be called as sp3 hybrid orbitals that are been formed because of the carbanion. And that is the reason that the carbon which has been present in the carbanion is basically sp3 hybridized, and because of which We know that if a molecule obeys or it gives sp3 hybridization, obviously the structure of that would be basically tetrahedron, and that's the reason that carbanion is the one that has a geometry of a tetrahedron. And we could see that this p orbital that would be there above, because this is the electron that we have seen, it has been fulfilled by the two electrons, or we could say it as it is nothing but the, and this is what it is, that is the lone pair of electrons that has been present over here. So that's the reason that we could see the geometry of the carbanion, it would be like this one. Suppose if we are talking about the methyl carbanion, and that's the reason that we could see that there would be three hydrogen that would be present, and this is the electron that has been present in the, that is p orbital, as you could see over here. So making this to be having a geometry of tetrahedral. So this is the geometry that I have mentioned over here. And even we have discussed about the carbanion has been formed. So now talking about the stability, stability is the one that it will be reverse of that of the carbocation. And that's it that I wanted to explain to you. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood that what is carbanion and how it has been formed, and what is the geometry or what is the hybridization of the carbon anion that has been giving a particular geometry. So that's it, and I hope you share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.